Hello, everyone. Thank you for coming. This is a wonderful thing that Kinacore is doing for us, allowing us to perform on stage for a live audience. Never had the opportunity to do that before. It's really incredible. We're very excited. I hope you enjoy yourself very much, and I hope that you guys all fall in love, have beautiful children like this one. Ice children. Children made of ice.
Cherries from my mouth, tapping the walnuts and
it started with that stick in the mud. Feathers where clouds are born. Clouds can't see where they are.
Shepherd on the moon, for your baby, be a granulated spoon, for your baby. I'd be a camper in a photograph for you. Then when the sun has set, romantic times have passed, and our conversations are bored, I'll become a different man, so you can get to know me. In a security in a Tibetan's head for you. Then when the sun has set, romantic times have passed, and our conversations are chore, I'll become a different man, so you can get to know me for your baby. I'd be a wrestler in a tuxedo shirt for you. I'd be an acid with a priority.
Thank you very much. And now, as you all probably know, we have a flair for the dramatic, and we're going to exercise that flair with a little play that we like to call The Events Leading Up to the Collapse of Detective Dullight, which is track one on the CD. If you wait for us to get ready and freeze, then play track one. Thank you very much.
There was jello in the fingerprints, Detective Dullight discovered. This proved to be the most important finding in the case. And whereas Detective Slox and Slavit slobbered over smutty photographs,
look at the size of those.
Dullight had a better lead to follow. He followed the ringing to the telephone, where a voice asked,
"Excuse me, are you so-and-so? Oh, so-and-so, since you left, I have been eating only sweets, 'cause they remind me of you."
He felt this surely was a clue. So he climbed into the tub, wearing his underwear and overcoat, jumped aboard the model boat, and followed the water down the drain. In his brain, there are file cabinets and secretaries filing their nails downstairs.
But I don't want to talk about that room downstairs.
At this moment, Detective Slocks and Slavitz realized that since they had reported on the crime scene this morning, each of them has aged over 50 years. Two butterflies land on their shoulders and harmonize softly in their ears. They held hands in the moonlight. The butterflies flew away, which prompted Slavitz to say,
"It's queer, but I miss them already."
Then Slox removed a fountain pen from his breast pocket, drove it deeply into Slavitz's throat, and began screeching,
"Thirst to the parchment world! The robot Imbecile!"
While in prison, Slox wrote one of the most revered exercises in free verse titled, "The Cause of Gauze."
Oh, the cause of gauze! The manuals have fondled many memories from my lap, though each memory has its own lap, and swimmers swim laps. Even swimmers have laps, however, and while in that condition, many require a delicate gauze. I desire only this in my decrepitude, that I will have one more opportunity to serve as a gauze for my fellow man, and that in that state of gauze can somehow disturb the world less often with my prickly fingers."
When Detective Dullight, returning from the catacombs, first heard the news of the Slocks and Slavitz stabbing and subsequent poetry enterprise, he immediately fell to the floor and began plucking peaches from his cheeks. This eventually became a tiresome activity, so he evaporated into the cream afloat a child's bedtime cocoa.
Bye.
In Babylon Japanese, I should let you know, this is a song off our record, The Gay Parade. Kevin has donned a special hat and is going to play the piano.
This is my French lieutenant's hat. This is a song about a French Canadian named Jaques Lamure. Oops. Our makeshift keyboard stand.
We'll try our best.
Ask those of you back at the board to play track 2 of the CD.
Look, Charlie, all I'm saying is she's nothing special. Why, I see 10 girls a day just like her out there on the thoroughfare.
Well, I don't think there's any girl out there like Elizabeth. And even if there were, Well, how would I find her? Well, gee, Freddy, I never thought of it that way. Hey, I gotta go.
Hey, Charlie, slow down. Where are you rushing off to?
I'm gonna go and find me one of them new girls. How many did you say there was? 10?
That's right. But say, Charlie, how long are you gonna be gone?
Until I find my...
for the retarded.
Thank you very much.
Just before the hour. wonderful to be here in Athens, Georgia. We came a long way from Michigan. Get to see what kind of suit my mom buries me in. I hope it's dark blue with blue stars. I hope it's dark blue with blue stars. I hope it's dark blue with blue stars. Over me, starts talking about Jesus and the state of my soul. Please remind him we're having a funeral here, not a play. We're having a funeral here, not a play. We're having a funeral here.
Thank you.
That was my brother. He played the part of the angel of death. But somehow I killed him in the end. I killed him with my shredding guitar solo. The inaudible one. That only angels of death can hear. Thank you. answer. He goes smash, showing everyone cheer. He turns big man to whimpering coward.
Thank you.
Thank you. Slow dreamy number, really.
Started the search. Nickee still sleeping soundly up in the little tree, and rushed back to tell the townspeople. After an owl translator was called in, and the owl's wonderful message was understood, the whole town joyously followed the owl back to the invisible tree, where little Nickee was still fast asleep. They all cheered when they saw her, and Nickee finally awoke and they lifted her above their heads and marched victoriously back up into town. They had a huge party to return.
Good to be home.